So I've been using the iPhone leather case for the iPhone 12 Pro since day one. It's actually 1 year since I've got it, and I've been using ever since, with only small gaps where I use the silicone case that I really enjoyed. But I always come back to this one because it has the MagSafe, which the other one doesn't. This is the Baltic blue color, because I have the Pacific blue iPhone 12 Pro and I wanted to have this match, and I really liked the color that you can see here on the box. I thought that it was a really interesting color and it matched really well the iPhone 12 Pro, but unfortunately the color changed quite a lot since day one. In this moment, the case looks still pretty good, the material is still okay. I don't really have any dents in it or anything like that, but the color changed drastically. And this is how it looks like in this moment, and in this lighting it looks almost black. Well, I can assure you that it's a bit of really dark blue. You can still see here around the edges the original color, so this is how it looked like initially, but overall the color changed completely. I still like it, and I think the color is still okay, but it doesn't compare to the original color. I think Apple did a really bad job this year with the coating, because I understand that you can have a really nice patina, and I was really expecting that patina to come up to this leather case, and especially since I've seen the patinas on the old iPhone cases. Considering that this is my first iPhone, I really wanted the leather case because I knew that people really enjoyed it, and the patina was really nice after a while. Unfortunately, it wasn't the case for this one, no pun intended. But in the end, I think overall the color, it's looking nice in this moment. I do get questions from people whenever they see this case. They are asking about the color because they know it's not something that Apple sells. But if it were me, I would have preferred the original color. But anyway, this is how it looks like in this moment. I do have to mention that it started to change color here around the edges, and it was almost this color that it's currently now. And I didn't like the aspect because I had really black colors here and here, but the overall color remained the same, especially here on the back. And I didn't like how it looked like because the difference was too big between the edges and the rest of the case. That's why I decided to wipe it off a bit, and I noticed right away that the color it's changing. And actually, I think you can still notice this color, so let me get a napkin and I will show you. Okay, so this is a regular napkin, and if I just wipe it off a bit, don't worry about the marks that appear on the case, because they will go back. But as you can see here, you can still see some blue coloring, some paint, or I don't know, that Apple put on their cases. So this is the reason why it's not actually a patina, and that's why I decided to wipe it off. Initially, I wiped it off in parts, and you can see some really interesting patterns. If I find some old photos, I will put them here on the screen. I kept it like that for a while. I really liked it, but in the end I decided to wipe it off completely, and I think the pattern still looks good, except for the colors around the buttons here and here, but that's okay. So overall, I think now the case still looks good, except for the color. I did have my concern initially, especially with the MagSafe, because this is also something that I've been using since day one, and at some point I could notice a ring around the MagSafe. That's why I decided to buy something for the MagSafe, and I had this velvet ring that I put here. And in this way you can barely see any ring. If there was anything during after the night, in the morning, then I can just wipe it off and it was no issues. But after a while I said I don't really care anymore. I don't really want to put a protection on my MagSafe charger, so that's why I removed it, and I kept using it like that. In the end, because I've wiped it, I don't really see any ring marks on it, so that's fine. And I've been using the MagSafe charger since day one, so that's not an issue for me. Overall, the quality is still good. There are some marks, but I've seen worse, and I think I can still wipe them off a bit, so that's not really an issue. As I said, I don't really have any dents in it, or no scuffs, so that's okay. So overall, it's still a good case, but to be honest, I'm still really disappointed about the color. I enjoyed the initial color, that's why I bought it. I know that this isn't the right color, but more or less it should have still looked like this. And you can see here how big of a difference is between the picture and the current case. You know, it's almost black in this moment. But overall, it's still good. You still have a pretty decent protection. I've been using for a bit a silicone case that it's a better fit in my opinion, but you don't have the edge protection that this one has. It will not help you with drop protection, but overall, from small drops or if you hit it, I think this will still be a good protection, and especially since this covers the screen a bit. So I cannot really show you the phone because I'm using it to film this video, but the edges are coming a bit higher than the actual screen, so that's okay. I like this protection. I'll continue using this case. I don't know how long I will still have the phone. It's a pretty expensive case. If I do change my phone, I don't know if it will be an iPhone or something else, but for sure it will not be another leather case from Apple. And as I said, it's actually today, it's been 1 year since I've got the case and I've been using it with my iPhone. So overall, it still looks good. The color is not so great, but hey, what can you do? I will still use it. The MagSafe is pretty good, so I'm fine with that. And as I said, I've been using it every night, so yeah, I will continue to use it. Anyway, this is my 1 year review, my final words for this case. Hope you liked it, and I hope it can help you out in making a decision for your device. Thank you for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.